Hello everybody, my sixth day, memorial number two. I am here in Daejeon. Where is Daejeon? So I traveled all the way across the peninsula and drove all the way far down in the middle, or a little bit even below South Korea in the middle. However, this region is extremely significant because following the first battle or defeat in Osan, the UN forces were continuously pushed down and they kept retreating. And here we are in Daejeon too. And sadly, out of the 12,000 in the 24th Brigade infantry, almost 1,000 died. And 2,200 were taken as prisoners of war, including Major Colonel William Dean. I'm just gonna try to read this. It says, to the heroes of the Daejeon battle, freedom is a lofty aim of man and the lifeblood of his soul. Eternal peace is another equally sacred ideal of man. Here was written page of the glorious story of the United Nations in its efforts to defend freedom and peace for mankind. The communist army, which launched a treacherous invasion into the Free South at the dawn of June 25th, 1950, continued its advance after occupying Seoul. As free nations of the United Nations rose in repelling the aggressions, the 24th Infantry Division, the vanguard of the United Nations forces, first engaged the enemy at Osan on July 5th. The enemy finally surrounded and attacked Daejeon here on July 17th. The 24th Division outnumbered, staged a furious defense which lasted for 20 days until its commanding general, Major General William Dean, was missing in action while commanding the battle at the front. This humble monument is dedicated to those heroic heroes of the 24th Division in defense of freedom and peace. March 31st, 1959. So I'm going to just show you around. Look, it says United Nations, of course, and I'm just going to give you a big tour. So one thing I love about this location, it was relocated to where we are now. It was built in 1959, the original one, but this was relocated here in 1975. Around here, it's a beautiful forest, okay? It's where Korean temples are. It was very difficult to find. However, this place is called the Forest of Healing, and there's like a cafe that says Healing Cafe. And I love that concept because I feel very calm and peaceful here already. And the whole idea of why I'm doing this is that, you know, I'm praying for reconciliation. I'm praying for healing. I'm praying for peace. And how wonderful it is that tomorrow, my last day, is the International Day of Peace. And I get to commemorate and honor the sacrifices of all the troops that came in defense, fighting for the United Nations. But again, not to glorify war, but to say thank you to my veterans, grandpas, and to remember them, and to honor them, and to really just pray and hope for peace. But I am extremely grateful because, look, I was joined to lay flowers by all these community leaders of this area, and to introduce them is my like my mentor and kind of like my godfather, President Park Sang-won from Los Angeles. He flew to Los Angeles to support me, and he's going to introduce his friends.
Okay, hi, good afternoon. I'm Sang-won Park. I'm working in, with President Hannah Kim. Also, I'm very honored to be a volunteer and a coordinator to help the Hannah Kim and remember 727. Let me introduce my members. Today, this residence and this community leader, Dr. Sangyol Baek, professor in Chungnam University. Also, he is the president of the Hungsadan Daejeon branch. Dr. Sangyol Baek and my Hungsadan member, Yu Ho-seok, he is also a volunteer and he is a whole life Hungsadan members.
Just to explain what Hungsadan is, Hungsadan were the freedom fighters of South Korea before the Korean War, when Korea was, you know, under Japanese colonialism. They fought for independence, and they are still carrying the legacy of the freedom fighters.
That's right. And then my another member is the Ji Bong-hak. This is a Hungsadan member. He working in a news media. Also people. And a former the Daejeon City Council member, name is Park Il-seok.
Yes, okay. What an honor that I have a former city council member of this region here with us. 한국말 하셔도 돼요. 시의원님, 이 기념비가 여기 있다는 게 되게 그죠? 너무 자랑스러운데 어떤 느낌이 드세요 오늘?
지금 대전 지구에 이런 전적비가 있다는 것은 얼마나 대단한 겁니다. 과거에 대흥동의 중심가 있던 것이 이리로 옮겼는데 와서 보니까 조금 서운한 것도 있습니다. 관리가 서운합니다. 그리고 우리 많은 시민들에게, 150만이 되는 시민인데 시민들한테 홍보가 부족하다. 우리 국민이면서 외국에서도 이렇게 오셔가지고 이런 걸 알리려고 노력하시는데 대전 사는 사람으로서 참 자주 못 오고
네, 많이 알려주세요. 예, 예.
여러모로 죄송스럽습니다.
아니에요. 예, 예. He said that, you know, as a former city council, that to see this beautiful monument here, it's his great pride. However, he regrets the fact that, you know, it is tucked away in a place where not a lot of people know about it. And he regrets the fact that, you know, it's not as, you know, well kept. And so he's going to do his best to let people know. So, 감사합니다. And 마지막으로 그래도 흥사단이 이제 그 freedom, 자유를 위해서 기억하고 감사하는 건데 한마디 해주세요.
네, 아무튼 그 한나 김 씨가 이렇게 10여 년 이상 이렇게 좋은 일을 하고 있다는 거를 제가 듣고서 굉장히 감명을 많이 받았습니다. 제 흥사단 역시 도산 안창호 선생님이 그 샌프란시스코에서 1913년에 창립하셔가지고 지금 105년 된 단체인데 그 독립운동과 여러 그 애국지사를 많이 그 육성한 단체가 흥사단이고 이런 그 행사에 저희들이 굉장히 의미가 부합되는 것 같아가지고 너무 고맙습니다. 그래서 앞으로 더 관심을 갖고 이런 쪽에 좀 같이 협조할 수 있는 부분이 있으면은 협조할 수 있도록 하겠습니다. 예, 감사합니다.
He says that he is proud to carry on the legacy of the freedom fighters and his organization has been in existence for 105 years. 제 어렸을 때 히어로 영웅이 누군지 아세요?
도산 안창호.
아니요. 유관순. I told them, do you know who my childhood hero is? It's 유관순. She's kind of like the Korean Joan of Arc. She fought for Korea's freedom on March 1st, 1919. But at the age of 16, she was captured and she died in prison. Right. But she is still my hero. And until this day, since I've been a child, all I pray for is that to have her courage. 그런 용기가 있는 사람이 되기를 저는 언제나 기도했거든요. 그래서 이렇게 같이 와주신 게 더 의미가 더 큰 것 같아요. So I said that I think it means more that they're here because that's what I'm doing, everybody. I'm just trying to do my part, whether I'm now a little bit older or not, to say thank you. I remember. And we will never forget. And we continue to fight for freedom because freedom isn't free.
Yes.
And neither is peace. Peace is not free. So we work hard for it. Remember 727.org. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.